to Python tutorial. In the previous video, we have discussed list concepts, list operations, list methods, and list functions. In this video, we will develop a Python program to accept n numbers from user, store into list, find the sum of all odd numbers and product of all even numbers entered in the list. So, the problem definition can be divided into number of tasks. The first task is to accept the number of elements. Second task is to accept the actual elements and store those elements into list. Third task is to calculate the sum of all odd numbers. Fourth task is to calculate the product of all even numbers. And the fifth task is to display the results. So first, we will create a variable n to store the number of elements in the list. So we use an input function to read the number of elements in the list. So we ask user to enter the number of elements in the list. As we know, the input function returns a string data. To convert string to int, we use the typecasting function int. Whenever the input is entered through keyboard, it will be converted into integer number and it will be stored into n. For example, the user can enter 4, 5 or 6, that is the number of elements to be stored into a list. Next, we try to read the actual elements. To read the actual elements, we need to use a loop, and loop should go or run for n number of times. So for I in range of n, this range function will generate numbers in the range in starting from 0 to n minus 1. For example, if n is equivalent to 5, it will generate the numbers starting from 0 till 4. The meaning of this one is this loop will run for 5 times. Now we need to read the actual element. So we create a variable, say ELE, and we will read the element. As we know, again the input will return the data in the string format, convert that into integer using int function, and input function enter the element. So once this statement is executed, the user will be given a prompt to enter the element. The entered element will be converted into integer format and it will be stored into ELE variable. Now we need to put this element into a list. So we need to create one list to store this elements. So for that reason, we will create a list. Let us say L1 is equivalent to list. This list contains no elements initially. Now once we read the first element, we put that element into this list. So L1 dot append of ELE. So we have used append function to put the element into L1. In the first iteration, the first element will be put into L1. In the second iteration, second element will be put into L1, and so on. Once all the elements were read, the next task is to find the sum of all odd numbers and product of all even numbers. So first we need to read the elements from the list L1, and then we need to check whether the number is odd. If it is odd, calculate the sum. If it is even, calculate the product and display the result. So again, we need two more variables. One variable is sum. Initially, sum is equivalent to 0. And then product is the one more variable, which is equivalent to 1. Initially, it is equivalent to 1. Now, we need to read the elements. So for ELE in L1. So what we are trying to do in this case is, we are trying to use for loop to read one element at a time from L1. So this loop will run for the number of elements present in the list. In the first iteration, it will return the first element and it will be stored into ELE. In the second iteration, it will return the second element and it will be stored into ELE, and so on. Now, once the element is available, we need to check whether that element is even or odd. So we need to check whether ELE mod 2 is equivalent to 0. ELE mod 2 is equivalent to 0 means the element is even. If ELE mod 2 is not equivalent to 0, the meaning of that one is the element is odd in that case. If element is even, we need to calculate the product. So product is equivalent to the previous product multiplied by the current element ELE. If it is not even number, we need to calculate, or we need to add the element to some variable, that's a previous sum plus the current element. Now it will run for all the elements. If the element is even, it will be multiplied to the previous product. If it is odd, the element will be added to the previous sum. Now, once the sum and product is available, we need to display the result. So we can display the results using print statement. Print sum of odd numbers is, that is sum, and second one is print product of even numbers is product. So we have done with all the tasks. We check the output and then we will summarize the program again. Now once you run it, the first line, it is asking us to enter the number of elements in the list. Let us say that there are 5 elements. So the first element is 1, second element is 2, third element is 3, fourth element is 4, and fifth element is 5. So the sum of odd numbers. So odd numbers in the list are 1, 3, and 5. If you add 1 plus 3 plus 5, we will get 9. And the even numbers are 2 and 4. And the multiplication of 2 and 4 is 8 in this case. We will summarize the program before we end the video. Initially, we have created a variable n to store the number of elements in the list. We have created one empty list, one variable to store the partial sum, and another variable to store the partial product. Initially, the partial sum is equivalent to 0 and partial product is equivalent to 1. We will use a loop to read the elements of a list. We read one element at a time, and using append function, the element is appended to the list. Once all the elements are read, we will go to the next task, that is calculating the product and sum. So first we read one element at a time from the list using for loop. If the element is even, that is ELE mod 2 is equivalent to 0, if it is even, we calculate the product, that is the previous product multiplied by the current element is equivalent to the current product. If ELE mod 2 is not equivalent to 0, that is odd number, the previous sum plus the current element is equivalent to current sum. The same procedure is repeated for all the elements. Once all the elements of list L1 are over, we display the sum of odd numbers, and then we display the sum of product of even numbers. I hope the program is clear. Do like the video, share with your friends, subscribe for the channel for more videos, and thank you for watching.